All right, everybody, welcome. I'm sorry for the fudge, man. Rowan, please stop screeching. Sorry. Anyway, yeah, my son was needing stuff, so kind of took me a little while. All right, let's see. Ice Krieg, welcome. May read an MMO. Nice. Our socials are in the link below. And you're making an MMO one day. Hey, man, do it. Just do it. I mean, even if you fail, you'll learn so much. And then, you know, the next time that you go to do it, you'll be able to do it again. You know, it's just you got to keep going. I mean, we've worked at this incrementally. We've had several different iterations. We've remade the game several times. You know, nothing wrong with that. We learned something new every time. We made progress every time. So, you know, just stick to it. Give it a try. If it doesn't work out, you know, I mean, obviously you can try something smaller if you want and feel like that you can achieve something. But at the same time, man, like, you don't have to feel like you have to start small. I know everybody says that, but you know, I know people who started learning game development with MMOs, and I know people who've made 2D MMOs you know, as their very, very, very first game. So you know, I say go for it, and you know, see where you land. And if you feel like you want to try something smaller, you know, do something smaller. If you feel like you want to try going at your MMO again, you know, regroup, start over, you know, start trying your MMO again. What are you using to achieve large player counts in Unreal? So we're using a system called ALS Refactored. The original ALS itself did not handle large player counts. However, ALS Refactored has a ton of stuff in it for optimization purposes. So you have thread safe animation instance logics. It has the reworked character movement for better movement synchronization over the network, which is super great. You know, there's all of this super great stuff in here for you know, achieving character movement. And then eventually, something else that I also want to do is include plugins. And then eventually what I want to do, and I'll show this to you as well, marketplace. So most of our monsters will be using this. Most of our non-humanoid monsters will be using this, but it's the generic generic movement. So the generic movement component. So all of our non-human characters will be using this system, because it supports all collision shapes, not just the capsules, which is huge for creatures that aren't humanoid in shape, right? So you can have as many collision shapes as you want. You can have whatever collision shape you want, and then the system itself has a huge amount of customization that you can do for synchronization across the network, and it really helps doing stuff. Unfortunately, this is a very expensive component. It's like $350 USD. So it is very expensive, but it will save you thousands of hours worth of work doing it on your own. This is what we're going to be using for non-hero movement, or non-humanoid character movement. And then eventually I'm hoping to integrate this into ALS Refactored and use this for the movement versus ALS, although it's going to be a while in the future before that happens. So I hope that answers the question. I meant in terms of server capacity, because normally Unreal Server can only handle about 100 players per server. Okay, so I'm going to be using a couple of different techniques. So number one, only movement. So right now, only movement and hitbox replication are going to be going through the Unreal Network. That way, we're minimizing the amount of traffic to the Unreal Network itself. So we're going to be able to expand our player movement by minimizing the amount of traffic that's going through the Unreal networking side of things. Things like questing, chat, variable replication, stuff like that, is actually going to happen through a WebSocket system, or maybe even gRPC. I'm not entirely certain. I haven't really decided on which one I'm going to go with yet. Both of them can handle, but I'm just trying to see which is going to work better at scale. And then from there, we're also going to be doing things like sharding and stuff like that. So we're going to be using something. Hang on, what's the name of it off the top of my head? One second. It's Agonies. There we go. So we're going to be using this system called Agonies, which is a self-hosted system. So we have our own servers that are in my house. They're in a separate area with their own connection and all that kind of stuff. But yeah, it's super awesome. And this is what we're going to be using to handle player instancing. So there's going to be about 250 people per channel, So we're going to be kind of gridizing the world. Let me see if I can. Okay. I'm gonna grid it here. Okay, yeah, my load's pretty good here. Sorry, my computer just went down the other day, so I am kind of I'm kind of like keeping an eye on everything because my computer like died on me the other day. So we're gonna be breaking our world into cells and subcells. So forgive the wonky drawing here. Imagine this is the world, right? So this is whatever map you're in. And then from there, you're going to have like a grid in it. Okay. And then, inside, so each one of these grids, right? So, let me do it this way. So you have, okay, so one second, guys. Sorry. Hello? All right, sorry, I received a telephone call. Here's how things will work. So each one of these cells is going to be what's known as a stacked instance. So if you think of each one of these cells as more than just a single cell, right? So you have think of them as kind of like 3D cells. And so instead of thinking about the 3D cell as in height, it's less about height and it's more about realms. So you can have each cell in total can have about 250 players. And then from there, you'll have you'll start having a couple of issues. If more people want to be in that area. So there are two techniques we're going to be using for managing that. The first one is going to be stacking. So you'll have each one of these will have a dedicated instance that is going to be server side. So it's what is known as vertical scaling. I don't know if you've ever heard the term. which is where you add more hardware to an existing workload. So vertically scaling its device would mean upgrading its CPU. And so for in this instance, though, we would be adding more threads. So you would be using more of the CPU, but you would have more more instances of that area, right? And then so you would have, so you would be, say you would be in realm one of 500, right? That's 506. Sorry, I'm actually not drawing on my screen. So you would be in realm one of 500, and so those would scale vertically, right? And then that would, you know, that would take care of most cases. But for the sake of argument, let's say that this cell fills up a lot of this, right? So this cell is kind of like full, right? In terms of its realm count and the amount of people that want to be in there. So there are still too many people trying to fill in. What we'll do then is we will actually start to sub-cell. So this cell will start to get split up into even more cells. And then each one of these will then start vertically scaling on its own as well. And so this cell will actually be running on a totally different server, and that is going to be known as that is known as horizontal scaling. So it's when you're adding more servers, so the load is distributed across multiple nodes. So what will happen is, as the cells start filling up, even the realms start filling up, we will start subgridding our existing grid into even smaller grids in the areas that are having super high traffic. And then those subgrids will run on a totally different server so that everything is running smoothly. So players could be connected to more than one server at a time. So to answer your question, will you have load screens or seamless transfer between cells? It will be seamless. So what will happen is when you start moving towards an area, so let's say you're in this cell and you start moving towards this way, what'll happen is you will get put in a transition state where you exist in both cells. And when you're in a corner like this, you'll actually exist in three cells. Technically four cells, in the one that you're in currently and in the other cells adjacent to it. It will attempt to smartly tell what cell you're going to go into. So it knows if you go to pass between here, it knows that you've clipped into this cell and you're going into this cell. So it will check to see, are there any players or objects in this area that need to be loaded as you're walking by? And if that happens, it will put you in all three of these cells. Otherwise, it will disregard loading this cell and only load this cell, and only load you into this cell, and you'll be in this cell until you leave. So there's a lot of systems kind of all working together, but what happens is that you have all of these different cells. Each cell has up to 200 realms, is which I know I have 500, but it was just, you know, for it was just a number. You would have 200 realms per cell, and then you transfer seamlessly between cells by loading into each cell. So you could be connected to several different servers or even several different game instances at one time. And then from there, if the load still is too high, we will then start subgridding, which will essentially make it easier on the server to handle.
Rowan, stop screeching, please.
And then we'll also, so your character, so let's say this is you, your character has a radius around you that you'll load, right? So that is going to be generally your visible distance, right? So it, your however far your camera can see is the distance around your character that the game is going to load objects and load you into cells. If the game becomes too heavy and we start subgridding, right, then the area around your character that you're going to be able to see things and things will load in is going to become much shorter. So you won't see characters that are further in the distance because we've then subgridded, and the amount of distance around your character in those grids areas will be smaller. But if this grid is heavy and then this grid is low and you go into this grid, your area will expand in this cell because that cell isn't as heavily occupied as the cell adjacent to it. I'm hoping all of this is making sense. Give me 1 second, though. I'm going to run and grab my daughter from my father and put her in her playpen. But if you have any questions in the meantime, feel free to ask them, and I will get to them when I get back. You are correct, Ice Krieg. But we are not switching scenes. We will be additively loading and unloading scenes from a base scene. So you will not be leaving the current scene. The other part of that is the Agoni's framework is a source plugin that also will help you resolve that issue.
Thank you.
So I have actually looked into open world server. I don't like how heavy-handed it is. It requires you to use their pawns. It has like a built-in ability system and all that stuff. I don't want to have to rip all that stuff out. Agonies is a system that doesn't do any of that for you. So for someone who may not really know what they're doing, when it comes to MMO design, open world server might be better for you. But for someone like me who's going to be designing all of our own systems pretty much from scratch, I kind of feel like, in my opinion, that Agonies is a better option for us. I am pretty good with C++ in Unreal. I'm good at C++ in general. I was actually a C++ developer before moving to Unity, which uses C#. And so it was kind of a natural move, you know, going to Unreal. Oh, they're not too bad. So if you, I don't know if you have a budget for your development, but, Rider really helps with a lot of this stuff. You know, if you start, right, you function, you property, and then generated body, you know, all that stuff. I mean, once you know what the macros are, you're fine. I would definitely use it. It's great. Let's close this guy for now. Replace those two files. There we go. I need to turn that off for Okay, so that will fix that problem. Okay, cool. I could run a build on this. I'll be right, guys. Right back, guys. Give me one moment. Thank you. All right, I am back. Sorry about that, guys. Okay, so we have... I say do it, man. Okay, all right, all right. Oh, this is gonna force me to do it, isn't it? Yep, it is. Oh. Will you please stop screaming? Rowan.
Oh, well, that really irks me. All right. Rowan, please stop. Okay, you can do that. You can do that too. Give Daddy 2 seconds, okay? All right, Bubba, hang on.
There we go. I'm assuming lots of drugs, but you'll have to ask James about that. He knew what I was talking about. Hey, look at that. It was drugs, I'm telling you. We have other people that cycle in and out, but we are pretty much the main two devs. Why does that feel choppy? Hold up. Does that feel choppy to you? Like, hang on. So this is game capture, okay? And then this is monitor capture. Did either one, like, are they the same or did they feel different? Here, I'll do game capture again. This is game capture. This is monitor capture. They look about the same to me through... They look about the same to me through the preview window, but...
Thank you.
Robert Green. Good job.
I'll be honest with you, it's been so long, I do not remember how me and James met. Was it through classifieds? Maybe? I could have been ModDB, but I doubt it. I wasn't much on ModDB. It had to be classifieds. The indie game dev classifieds. It had to be through there. I mean, me and James do pretty well. We've had our fights, but we always come to some kind of amicable, you know. Rowan, please give it a rest. I'm gonna be testing out some. I'm gonna be testing out weapon swapping. So, creating an animation controller per weapon swap. I do all the work and James watches. That's pretty much how it works.
Did I sound like I was joking? There you go. There's your answer. I mean, James, you're welcome to refute this if you want, but I have years of video evidence.
I'm joking. James has done a lot in terms of like planning, getting together like art assets, and helping plan out quest lines, you know, kind of where creatures will be in the maps and stuff like that. But in terms of development work, it's usually me.
What?
No, he's more like administration, I guess, would kind of. No, not administration. He's more on the planning side of things, where I'm more on the development side of things. I mean, I'm totally joking about him just watching. Like he does a lot of stuff behind the scenes, but it's, you know, when it, I'm not joking when I say when it comes to development, it is mostly me. Yeah, he does a lot of marketing. Yeah. All right, that was weird. Anyway. Are you talking about kicks again? I don't know, man. I wouldn't quite call it live or consistently updated. I mean, by the time you got me in on it, it was fucking dead. Like, even when you had me write that bot, it was pretty fucking dead back then. And none of the players could make any fucking, like, they couldn't make any decisions. That was what, like, threw me off on that thing. It's like, you had me come in to help, like, when the server went down and everything, you're like, hey, I have this guy that can host it. And they're like, well, we're going to have this other person host it. And then you guys had like a big vote and everybody voted to have me host it. And then all of a sudden they're like, no, we're going to have this other guy host it for no reason. They didn't know what they wanted to do.
Okay. What, kinks? Yeah, it kind of looked like trash. I mean, my understanding is it had a following, like it had a pretty decent following. Nobody liked that one, though, did they? I remember you saying that it didn't have features that the original had or something like that, or that they changed the way things worked and people weren't a huge fan of it. Rowan, quit screeching, please. Just testing everything out, see how everything's working. Properly on the map. Ocean's looking good. Rowing. So I'm thinking about replacing the I'll tell you what I mean. But I'm thinking about replacing the ocean that we have on this map with this one, and you'll see why here in a second. Oh, you guys aren't even seeing it. So this is why I'm thinking about replacing the ocean that we had on that map with this one. Is that not a fucking pog ocean? Like fucking poggers, dude? Like straight out poggers? But yeah, this is what I'm thinking about using for the ocean. I gotta figure out how it actually works though before I just jump into like throwing it in here. But that's a new one I picked up a little while ago, and it's come along pretty far, so I'm excited about trying it out. What are you gonna do? My son's hilarious. All right, so how am I looking? I'm looking pretty good. Yeah, I'm looking pretty good. I'm above 60, so I'm excited about that. Yeah. Stop staring at my arrow dong, everybody. Jeez. You guys have dirty minds. Rowan, what are you doing? Leo is a really bad person, Bubby. Alrighty, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and end the stream for now. I got some stuff I gotta do, and we've been streaming for about 2.5 hours. I intend on coming back to this and getting some stuff going, but I'm super excited about what we've done. So yeah, again, thank you guys so much for watching. We will be back here. I don't know, might be later tonight, might be tomorrow, but we will be back. So if you guys like what you see, please hit the follow button, and we will see you guys in the next one. Peace.